Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Our project title is Traffic Decorrelation Techniques for Countering a Global Eavesdropper in Wireless Sensor Networks. Abstract. In wireless sensor networks, the end-to-end data communication is needed to collect the data from source to destination. Collected data are transmitted in a path consisting of connected links. All existing end-to-end protocol propose a problem in case of opportunistic network is continuously changing network topology. Connections are not stable. Nodes depend on intermediate nodes to send message to destination. Selection of appropriate relay nodes is quite difficult. The FBFF AOMDB protocol selects a route based only on the minimum hop count by using fitness functions and provides secure data transmission in the communication. The fitness function is used to find the optimal path from source to destination node to reduce the energy consumption in multipath routing. This process considers maximal net energy neighbor for routing the packets. The TBFF AOMDB protocol is enhanced the construct network with maximal energy. For the performance evaluation, the packet delivery ratio drop packets and the energy consumed per packet matrices were analyzed using NS2 simulator by varying energy ranges. The observed results prove that there is a substantial increase in packet delivery ratio and a decrease in dropped packets and the energy consumed per packet. Let us see the flow of our project. In our flow, we have to form the network using our network parameters such as channel layers, energy models. So the position is nothing but the XY direction of each node. So for obtaining the position of each node means we have to then find the neighbor of the source and destination. So this is obtained by using neighbor discovery module. So after that we have to calculate the trust. So the node which is in trust basis means we have to transfer that data packets to via that trusted node. For that we use FBMM TBFF AOMDB routing protocol. This routing protocol generates routing table for each transmission. The packet is sent via the trusted node to destination. This is called the best communication, which is done via the best neighbor nodes. The performance is analysis by using packet delivery ratio, delay, energy and throughput. Let us see the output of our project. For running our NS2 process, we need VMware workstation. So I am now going to run our process in command prompt. For that we have to switch on our command prompt window. So next, change directory to our code folder. So this is the syntax for running our main file, which contains the extension of TCL. So now the position velocity of each node is calculated for the time. So at the time 30 seconds finishes means it will be open our network animator window. Now the time is 15. So the position is nothing but the x, y, z direction of each and every node which is placed in our network. So we use flat grid topography, which is nothing but the flat which is not, doesn't contain any grids. So now the process time is 24. At the time of 24, it will open the NAM window. So when we click on this play forward means it will be works. Now I am going to set time limit for 20 ms. So our network contains 100 number of nodes. Green color denotes the energy model, so we have to set energy model in our process. Energy model is nothing but the parameters of transmission power, reception power, idle power and sense power are set manually. So now the dynamic process for source and destination is selected. So if the source and destination is in further means, it will be transmit the data we are the best communication of hop. So now the data transmission is done. So data transmission is done via the neighbor. So this is for shortest path routing. So now the data transmission for source to destination is done via the neighbor with 1098 bytes. This process is for dynamic. All the nodes are in mobility. For that we use random mobility model. This is the process for running our process. So now I am going to run our graph. So we use GNU plot for running our graph. So type GNU plot space THR dot plot for calculating throughput of our system and the existing system. So this is our throughput which is denoted as bytes per second. So next graph is delay graph. Delay dot plot. So this is the comparison between the existing and the proposed system of our delay. The next graph is PDR, packet delivery ratio. So we have to achieve a high packet delivery ratio than the existing system. Thank you for watching.